गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, लेट अस स्टार्ट द न्यू चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 8, रीचिंग ग्रैंड मदर्स हाउस। दिस चैप्टर इज इन कंटिन्यूएशन विद अर्लियर टू चैप्टर, ओमानाज जर्नी एंड फ्रॉम द विंडो। सो लेट स्टार्ट द चैप्टर। 17th मे नाइट एंड टाइम इज 11:30 PM। आफ्टर अवर लॉन्ग ट्रेन जर्नी वी रीच कोट्टयम इन द नाइट। कोट्टयम इज इन केरला। Valiamma's house was not far from the station and we had to take two auto rickshaws to get there. So Valiamma means mother's elder sister. And from the earlier chapter we came to know that this language is Malayalam language. By then I was very sleepy and did not even wait to eat anything. I took a bath and slept. I thought I had just fallen asleep when Amma woke me up again. We got ready, took our luggage and went to the bus stand. Valiamma's family also came with us. We were 10 people and had a lot of luggage too. So how many people? 10 people. And how many auto rickshaws they took? They took 2 auto rickshaws. Okay, the bus conductor came and Appa bought tickets for all of us. We managed to get seats as it went along. The bus got very crowded. People were sharing the seats. We also had to share our seats. After a long ride, the bus reached the last stop. I was happy to get off. My legs were stiff. I could hardly stand. So, after a long ride, the bus reached the last stop. And why her legs were stiff? Because the bus was very crowded and they were sharing their seats. I thought that we had finally reached Amu Amma's village. Again, Amu Amma's mean, in English it means mother's mother, that means grandmother. But no, our travel had not ended yet. The bus had dropped us by the waterside. Look, Amma pointed across the water. That is where we have to go. But how will we get there? I wondered. So after getting down, there was river, and Omana was thinking how she will go to the other side of the river. Just then I saw a boat coming. There is the ferry. So underline the word ferry. Amma said immediately a big crowd of people started getting off. The school children, men, women, all with their own packets and luggage. So different peoples were there. And who were the different peoples? School children, men, women, and they were carrying their packets and luggage. Amma explained that the ferry was used by the people to cross the water and reach the other side. Now, why ferry were used? The ferry were used, ferry are used by the people to cross the water and to go to the other side. As soon as the ferry got empty, the big rush started from our side. Everyone had to pay the fare before getting on. Very soon the ferry was full and it started off again. So from this paragraph we came to know that we have to pay for the ferry also. I managed to get a place to stand along the railing. Look here, the picture of ferry is there. These are the railing. Okay, this man is standing near the railing. I saw the rippling of the still water as the ferry moved. Now what is rippling? It is the sound of the water. It was moving smoothly on the water. There were rows of coconut trees on the banks of the river. As we moved swiftly, I could see people fishing, washing, bathing and working along the banks. So along the banks, what were the people doing? Some people were fishing, some were washing, bathing and working along the banks. But do you know, children, that fishing is okay, but washing, bathing makes the river water dirty. Now let's move on to the next page. Just before the sun disappeared into the water, the ferry reached the island and stopped. It was time for us to get off, last. We reached Amu Amma's place. What a long and interesting journey it has been. Now, for today, this much is enough. So, based on these two pages, I am going to give you some questions to do. Thank you.